Hello and welcome to the session on the topic lattices under the course Discrete Mathematical Structures at Information Technology Engineering, second year, semester 1. At the end of this session, students will be able to classify algebraic systems as lattices. The flow of the session is lattice, its definition. We are going to learn new terms, sublattice with its definition and examples, and a direct product with its definition and examples. Now, as we have already learned lattice as a partially ordered set, pause for a while and try to answer this question. Can we consider a lattice as an algebraic system? So, based on the answer, we have one more definition coming along for a lattice. Earlier, we have defined lattice to be a partially ordered set. Now, as we have already learned what is an algebraic system as well, it is a system consisting of a partially ordered set along with two binary operations. We can define a lattice also to be an algebraic system. And that will be a more useful definition when it is applicable to theory of computer science. So, here is a definition for lattice as an algebraic system. A lattice is an algebraic system, L, star, plus, with two binary operations, star and plus, on L, which are both first commutative, second associative, and third satisfy the absorption laws. Now, again, discussing about the definition, first of all, we observe that we have called this lattice as an algebraic system. So, that is how the notation changes to. Earlier, we only described the lattice to be a partially ordered set as L, some relation such as less than or equal to. Now, here we have replaced the partial order relation by two binary operations, namely star and plus. And we say that these are the operations which hold the following properties. And what are those? Number one, commutative, number two, associative, and that too satisfying one of the important properties of lattices that we have learned, called as absorption laws. Okay, so this is how we describe a lattice to be an algebraic system. So based on this, since we have described a lattice to be an algebraic system, we are now going to define a subsystem out of this, which will be of more use for us, and that will be termed as a sublattice. So here comes the next definition for a sublattice. Let L, star, plus be a lattice, and let S be a subset of L. The algebra or the algebraic system S, star, plus is called a sublattice of L, star, plus if and only if S is closed under the operations star and plus. So, this is how we get a sublattice out of a lattice. So, always the sublattice will be derived from some lattice. So, here we say L, star, plus is a lattice, and then we define S being a subset of L, a new algebra or an algebraic system, S, star, plus. Note that the two binary operations remain same in the new algebraic system as well, such as star and plus. And then we say S, star, plus will be called as a sublattice if and only if there are two conditions to be satisfied, that is both the operations star must be closed, the sets must be closed under both the operations star as well as plus. So now, as earlier we have described, we can replace the two operations, namely star and plus, by any two pair of operations such as less than or equal to and greater than or equal to, or union and interaction, intersection, and dot and plus, and so on and so forth. So these are only the notations that we use to denote some binary operation. So we derive a subset, and then we say if both the new algebraic system is closed under two operations, it is termed as a sublattice. Now the question arrives, what do you mean by closed under these two operations? So we have learnt what do you mean by closed under some operation. It is simply, if you perform the operation of star as well as plus on any two elements of the given set, the result that you get also belongs to the same set. That is what we mean by closed under the operations star and plus. That is, if you take example of two elements A and B from the subset S, and there is one more element C in the same set, and we say, observe that if you perform A star B and that results into C, and there is one more element D in the same set S, and if you perform A plus B and that is equal to D, which is also a part of S, then we say, since the result is also contained by the same subset S, both the operations star and plus are closed under the two operations. It is simply, whatever result you obtain after performing the operations, you must find the element also present in the same set itself. So that is how we define a sublattice. So let us see an example of the same. Let L comma less than or equal to be a lattice. So here we have used the earlier notation as an partial order set, L comma less than or equal to be a lattice in which L is equal to some set, and S1, S2, S3 be the subsets of L given by S1 equal to A1, A2, A4, A6, S2 equal to A3, A5, A7, A8, and S3 is equal to A1, A2, A4, A8. Now, we find S1 comma less than or equal to S2 comma less than or equal to are sublattices of L comma less than or equal to. Here, we must note that L contains certain elements A1 to A8 that is missing. We write the elements of L as A1, A2, A3, A4, etc. up to A8, and then we define these new subsets S1, S2, S3. So now S1 comma less than or equal to and S2 comma less than or equal to are sublattices of the given lattice, because both the operations star as well as, sorry, if you perform star such as A2 star A4, which results into A6, is also present in L, but if you perform the same operation, it is not an element of S3. So S3 comma less than or equal to is not a sublattice. Fine. So, but if you consider S3 comma less than or equal to as a separate algebraic system, then you find that it satisfies all the properties of a lattice. So we say S3 comma less than or equal to is a lattice. Next, we have one more definition coming along, which is again based on lattices. Let L comma star comma plus and S comma disjunction comma conjunction. As we have already said, we can use any pair of symbols to denote certain operations. So here we are using the disjunction and the conjunction, B2 lattices. The algebraic system L cross S comma dot comma tilde, these are again any two pair of symbols that we can use to denote, in which the binary operations tilt and dot in L cross S are such that for any ordered pair A1 B1 and A2 B2 in L cross S, we find A1 B1 dot A2 B2 is equal to A1 star A2 comma B1 conjunction B2. Similarly, if you perform A1 B1 tilt A2 B2, then you get A1 plus A2, B1 disjunction P2. This is called the direct product of lattices L, star, plus and S, conjunction, disjunction. Thank you.